Now, one of the reasons that we have ESD protection on an Ethernet interface or on any of the connectors or any of the other mechanical stuff that goes into Ethernet is because there is a galvanic isolation requirement as well as an ESD withstand requirement. Now, the galvanic isolation requirement also applies in the isolated DC-DC converter that you would use in PoE. And in fact, there are PoE-specific mag jacks that you can use if you're going to use PoE in your system. Now, if you're going to have a connection to chassis ground using a TVS diode, you just need to be aware that you need to actually have a chassis in your design in order to make that connection. Not all designs that have an Ethernet port have a metallized chassis ground. However, you can still have a chassis-like ground if you want, and you can have that placed as a guard ring around the edge of the PCB. If you divert ESD or any other kind of transient pulse into that guard ring around the edge of your PCB, it's going to keep it away from any of the components that are at risk of damage should ESD occur. So consider using that, especially in the case where you don't have a metallized chassis for your enclosure. Now, you can always do both. You can have a guard ring and you can have a metallized chassis, and you can basically connect the two together if you want. Your choice on how to do that. Of course, no matter what you do, make sure that you apply ESD testing on your device after you prototype it to make sure it's going to meet the Ethernet standard.